Multiply rational expressions, you can divide them. Just like if you can multiply regular fractions, you can divide them also. There's just one little step that gets added on. So let's take a look at a division problem that deals with just basic numbers, and then we'll transfer that into a rational expression problem. So let's say that we have 14 divided by 24, or over 24, and then we're dividing that fraction by the fraction 21 over 32. If you remember back to when you divided these regular fractions, the rule was that you took the reciprocal of what you were dividing by, which in this case is going to be this 21 over 32. And taking the reciprocal means you flip it over, and then you switch this division symbol into a multiplication. So that turns this problem into 14 over 24 times 32 over 21. Notice that it just changed the second half of the problem around, and now it is a multiplication problem just like the problems we just did. So now we can go ahead and match things up that can cross cancel. And I notice that 7 goes into my 14 twice and into my 21 three times. Now if I look at what's left, I can go ahead and divide 8 into my 24 three times and 8 into my 32 four times. Now, if I look at what's left, be careful. There's a common mistake people do. They will notice that 2 and 4 can cancel, but notice 2 and 4 are both in the numerators. You have to have one in the numerator and one in the denominator. These are both in the tops of the fractions. You can't cancel them because we need something down here. Similarly, these 3's will not cancel because they're both in the bottom of the fractions. So, since we don't have something in the numerator and the denominator to cancel, we have simplified as far as we can. So, we're going to multiply straight across. 2 times 4 gives us our 8. And in the numerator, our 3 times our 3 gives us our 9. And that's as far as we can go with this particular problem. Those steps we just did of flipping your second fraction over and switching to multiply, and then following the process for multiplication, is exactly what we're going to do with rational expressions. So let's take a look at a problem with rational expressions. Let's say that you have x squared minus 2x minus 35 over x squared minus 49, and you're trying to divide that by x squared minus 25 over x squared plus 7x plus 10. Now, the first thing that we want to do is go ahead and flip our second fraction over so that we have x squared plus 7x plus 10 in the numerator, and in the denominator you have an x squared minus 25. And instead of division, we now have multiplication. The first expression we're just going to copy down exactly the way it was. And now what we need to do is go through each of our sections and factor them. So we're going to start with the numerator of the first expression. And I notice it's got three terms and our leading coefficient is 1 here. So I'm going to look at the negative 35 and see how could I come up with a negative 2 in the middle. And I notice that 5 times negative 7 is negative 35, and 5 plus negative 7 is negative 2. So the numerator there is going to factor into x plus 5 times x minus 7. Now let's look at the denominator of the first expression, this one here. There's two terms, and they're both perfect squares. This first one here is x times x, and the second one is 7 times 7. So this one's going to factor into our difference of squares pattern because those two perfect squares are subtracted. So it will be x plus 7 times x minus 7. Now let's look at our second expression. Over here, this particular one here has three terms, and our leading coefficient here is 1. So things that will multiply to get 10 and add up to 7, I notice, would be 5 times 2 and 5 plus 2. So this will factor into x plus 5 times x plus 2. Now let's look in our denominator. If we look at the denominator here, that again is a difference of squares, and 25 is 5 times 5, and x squared is x times x, so this will factor into x plus 5 times x minus 5. Now let's see what we can pair up. And I notice right away these x minus 7s, and then I also notice I have 1 x plus 5 in the denominator here, so I need to either pair it up with 1 right above it or the 1 diagonally, but not with both of them. So I'm going to go ahead and cancel it with the 1 right above it. And then look at what we have left, and you can get your solution. So we have the fraction x plus 5 times x plus 2, because that's all that's left in the numerator, over x plus 7 times x minus 5. And that would be your final solution. So that's how you go about reducing fractions, rational expressions, multiplying rational expressions, and dividing them. So you can go ahead and try your problems that deal with those three concepts.